2 years ago, out of high school with a 4.0 GPA, I was rejected by every single university that I applied to. Fast forward to now, I'm attending one of the world's best computer science programs in the whole world. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about how I transferred to UC Berkeley as a computer science major. Hi, my name is Arda, and I'm a junior transfer studying computer science here at the University of California, Berkeley. I graduated from high school with high hopes of getting into a good four-year school for computer science major. I was applying to a lot of different programs, mostly UCs, and I got rejected by every single one of them. And then that was a very big shock for me, as I had a 4.0 GPA. I did a bunch of extracurriculars in high school. I was in a sailing team. I was in a badminton team. I created my own club where we've done a lot of successful things. And I was recognized by two different departments of my high school, as well as getting a scholarship for my high school, which was awarded to only one of three students. But I was rejected from the 4 years. So rather than going to out of state to a non-target university or in-state non-target university, I decided to attend community college for 2 years and then transfer. My journey started 5 years ago when my family came to the United States for better life standards and for better education for me and for my brothers. I didn't know any English at the time, and right after, just after 4 months of moving into the United States, COVID-19 happened, where we weren't able to socialize. I wasn't able to learn the language. I wasn't able to talk with others, make friends. So I decided to create my own club. I created a Turkish club. I realized that not many people knew about my culture. So I started teaching my culture via Zoom meetings. I collected a few friends. I started hosting Zoom meetings. And once we initially transferred to in-person learning, I started doing meetings in person with free food and then more presentations about my culture. And with a lot of community service events, we volunteered at San Diego Food Bank. We've done a bunch of beach cleanups. We went to St. Jude's Hospitals to give a Valentine's card to kids with cancer. We organized various events for senior citizens in our community. And I was the one who was organizing these, and the club members were able to benefit from these as community service hours, because they're valuable when you're applying to 4 years. So I was like, here, I'll teach you about my culture and you're gonna be gaining community service hours and make your application even stronger, so you should join my club. I was only Turkish in my club at the start, and then we were only two Turkish people. And towards the end, we had over 50 members. That was my high school story. And then moving on to community college, as soon as I graduated from high school and got my rejections, I didn't wanna lose any time. So I signed up for community college, met with a counselor. And the first counselor I met at my community college said it was impossible for me to transfer to a four-year university CS major in 2 years. Luckily, I had a friend who was a year ahead of me, and he was already on track of doing it. I was like, well, my friend is doing it. Looks like you're not going to be any help. So I just moved on, and then as soon as I hung up with her, I made another appointment with another counselor. He was more helpful, and then he was able to guide me through the classes I need to take and how to, navigate through assist and all those. So I started by taking summer classes, and then continuing on, I was taking 20 to 21 units each semester, including summer. And during summer, I was taking 8 to 10 units as well. And I was also involved in my Associate Student Government at Community College. I hold an executive position as the chair of Inner Club Council, where I was overseeing all the student clubs on campus and managing a $60,000 budget. So I went from being the president of a club in high school to managing over 50 student clubs and organizations in my community college. And on top of these, I was able to get good grades in community college. And then when it was time for applying universities, the most important thing is obviously your PIQs. Speaking of UC's UC system, I didn't apply to any private universities as I cannot afford it. So my target schools were UC, specifically UC Berkeley, LA, and San Diego. So as English as a second language, it was really important for me to write a proper top-notch PIQs. And for this, I was utilizing the writing center that my community college had. If you have a writing center in your high school or community college, take advantage of it. If you don't, reach out to your professors and teachers individually and ask for feedback. I was probably there more than like 50 times, and I met with more than 20 people and just reviewing my PIQs, making them like perfect, where we thought of like every single minor detail to make it perfect, flow perfectly. So my story basically. And on top of that, I was able to get a internship at Scripps Research in the Cancer Research Lab, with no experience in both biology, cancer research, wet labs. I didn't have any experience, but I had experience with computers, and I was able to market myself on the spot when I first met with my supervisor by pure coincidence. I'm gonna be diving deep into finding internships with no experience and all the stuff that I'm talking about, let me know down in the comments what you want to hear. Wrapping everything up, I had a good package of applications. I was hopeful, but I knew that computer science was one of the most competitive majors out there with acceptance rate around 2-5%. But that didn't stop me from applying to every UC again for computer science major. And this time, I actually got into all of them, and I chose UC Berkeley for obvious reasons. Challenges and how I overcame them. Staying motivated in community college requires a lot of self-discipline and self-motivation, as you're gonna be seeing your peers going to four-year universities and not really caring about their grades and just partying and going to various places while you're in a community college trying to get good grades, because it is really important to get good grades, especially for competitive majors. Staying self-motivated is really important. What I helped me to stay self-motivated was much just like ambition to, you know, achieve things. And I want to prove myself, that I can get into these top universities. What life is like at Berkeley now, I'm super happy with my living situation, with my classes, with my professors, with my friends. It's really nice here. Coming up here, I was worried about the weather and, you know, the competitiveness. It is competitive, but there is still things to do, and you know, the social scene of Berkeley, and so far really enjoying it. Obviously it's not like the biggest party school in the States, but I mean, I'm coming from a party last night, but I'm still able to, you know, manage good academics with good social life. I'm not overloading myself, I'm not comparing myself with others. At Berkeley, I'm not looking to get straight A's, as the classes are 10 times harder than community college classes. If I have to put my life at Berkeley under three categories, it would be your living situation, your classes, academics, and your social life. I got really lucky with my living situation, where I transferred here with my friends from my same community college and we rented an apartment. It is very important to have good roommates, because at the end of the day, this is where you're going to be like spending most of your life and sleeping and, you know, your basic life. And if you don't have good roommates, if you're doing the dorms in university housing, good luck. Academics, I'm not overloading myself. I'm taking 12 to 15 units. I am trying to take advantage of all the opportunities like research and internships and different side projects and startups. And social life, I am trying to meet with as many people as possible. I'm trying to make as much connections as possible, getting into different organizations, meeting with new people, and then learning about them, learning about their career goals. So life at Berkeley so far, 10 out of 10. Overall, my advice for future transfer students is make sure you're meeting with different counselors all the time, and meeting with a lot of counselors, because counselors are humans and they make mistakes. If I didn't meet with a counselor last minute, I was missing a single class, that would prevent me from going to UC Berkeley. So I'm really grateful for that counselor for catching that small adjustment in my class schedule. When you're in community college, it's not only about your classes, so get involved with clubs, get involved with student government if possible. Try to get internships. I know it's hard, but it is numbers game. Like for example, right now, I applied to more than 200 internships for upcoming summer, and I had around like 10 interviews, and I had only one offer, which I'm really grateful for, but it's basically numbers game. Don't get disappointed when you apply to 50 jobs and don't hear anything back. It's numbers game. It's apply to as much jobs as possible. Try to see if you can reach out to people on LinkedIn, do networking, ask, you know, ask friends and family to see if they know anybody. Lastly, a piece of advice for students that are doubting themselves if they can transfer to a good university or not. It's not only, UCs are not only looking at your grades or your academic achievements, but they're looking at you as a person. So try to grow as much as possible as a person and reflect that on your UC applications. And I'm gonna be diving deeper into these various areas in the futures as well. Overall, if you're thinking about transferring, I promise it is possible. Drop any questions in the comments and I'll be happy to help. Let me know what kind of videos you guys want me to make. And thank you for watching. See you next time.